back to my channel. Today we're gonna jump back into the world of football. We've been there plenty of times before, but we've nowhere near seen everyone that we need to see. And I cannot wait to see this person. We're gonna take a look at Walter Payton, someone that I have been recommended a couple of times in the comments, and also I've also had recommendations from friends as well to take a look at, so I can't wait. I want you guys to join me, and we're just gonna go ahead and start off with our same old run through. Because when it comes to multiple sports, there's like a bunch of different positions. There's a bunch of like, there's offense, there's defense, there's just, everyone plays an intricate role. There's no way I can just watch one person and just know the whole sport at all. So I'm learning so much. I'm learning so much from these videos, and I'm learning a ton from you guys. So I just want you guys to know that I appreciate all that you guys do for me down in the comments. So do not stop giving comments and helping me out. But now, let's go ahead and get started. Alrighty, here we go. Alright, so Walter Payton, let's see what he looks like. So here he is. This is a rather serious look he's got going on here with that. He's a nice looking guy. So there's a nice smile, so he doesn't look so serious. But I'm sure he means business. Now let's go ahead and look at some information from him. So his name is Walter Jerry Payton. He was born July 25th, 1954. Position is a running back, number 34. He played, he played for the Chicago Bears in the NFL. And let's see, what else do we have? He was born in Columbia, Mississippi. He died November 1st, 1999 at the age of 45. Oh my God, what a young age to pass away at. May he for sure rest in peace. In South Barrington, Illinois is where he passed away at. He was 5'10", 200 pounds. He went to high school in Columbia, Mississippi. Went to Jackson State for his college. And as far as the NFL draft, he was round one, pick four in 1975. He played for the Chicago Bears his entire career, 1975 to 1987. So he stuck it through one team throughout his career. And as far as his highlights and awards, we have, let's see, Super Bowl champion, 9-time Pro Bowl, 7-time first team All-Pro. What else can we kind of skim through here? NFL Offensive Player of the Year, NFL Man of the Year, NFL Rushing Yards Leader. Let's see, NFL rushing touchdowns leader. These are all 1977, so 1977 must have been one heck of a year for him. What else do we have? 4-time NFL rushing attempts leader, NFL 1970s all-decade team, just a bunch. They retired number 34 from the Chicago Bears, also in reference to him. Now, as far as his NFL statistics, his rushing yards was 16,726. Yards per carry is 4, rushing touchdowns 110, 492 receptions with 4,538 receiving yards. And as far as receiving touchdowns, he has a total of 15, so that's awesome as well. So that's just a little bit of information to kind of get about him for those that may not know, like me, of what else he has, what all factors into his career there. But now, let's go ahead and see him in action. So let's go, guys.
It's sad to me because he had a lot greater impact on my life than I had on his. And he was the best football player I've ever seen.
That's a huge thing.
And probably one of the best people I've ever met.
Not only is my dad an exceptional athlete, he's a role model. He's my biggest role model and best friend. We made a wager who would be the first one to break down and tear. And after hearing my son get up here and talk, I don't care if I lose the bet.
Aww. How cute and sweet is that? I know that there's the nickname Sweetness, and now that I'm like thinking about just hearing his speech and stuff, is that why they called him Sweetness? Is it because he was like a sweet person as well, or a very nice individual? That's kind of my question. You guys let me know in the comments. Ooh. Jeez, he's still going? man, that's one powerful runner, that's for sure. The heck was he still going? Dang, we just jumped over them. He's over here playing leapfrog on the field. His legs like go when he's like running, like it's almost like he's just skipping out there, just boom, boom, just trucking through people. Oh my goodness, seems like he takes it as a challenge not to go down. Look at him go. I like how he threw that stiff arm out while he was still running. Kept control of the ball. He's got some moves too that keeps him running, keeps him going. Ooh, that was really nice. And he got away clear, knew which way to go, just very aware of the field at all times. Look at him. Straight through you, man. Like, one thing for sure I do love is how running backs, they kind of like plot their course. They basically visualize where they're about to go and where they're going, and then they just boom, hit it. It's almost like watching them kind of like cars or trucks on a freeway. They're like seeing the lane, they view the lane, then if there's a car in the way or whatever, they merge over to the other lane and take off. He jumps over all these people, and he's not even huge, 5'10", jumping over a whole mountain of players. Wow. And all that commotion. Look at him, he's like, it's either me or you that's gonna break in reference to going down, but it ain't gonna be me, because he is gonna either go through you or take you with him. But he's still gonna be standing and make sure he gets to that touchdown first, that end zone. That's pure will and determination right there. Woo. Wow. Ooh, oh, yikes. That was straight on, boom. Look, I like how he did that. He cut, like he's seen the guy coming towards him, paid attention, cut over to the inside in between both of them with no fear whatsoever as to what was gonna happen to him and just kept going. Good way to help him out. Just straight up the middle of them, like nothing. Took it to the outside, he's gonna go for a touchdown. Look at him. Nice. Man. It's almost like he's just unstoppable, period. He is not going down until he's at the end. Jeez. How you fight? He's jumping pretty high. 5'10". He's doing it. Gonna just cut straight through. Boom. He's got a straight up great leaping ability, period. Like, how? He's got springs in his legs. And he's like a bowling ball, and these guys are the pins. Like, going straight through you, gonna knock you over. The passion from the fans. Look at how small he is compared to that guy. Seems like his team really loved him as well. It says like a lot about him. We watch at the beginning with him and his son, and then we watch him here on the field, and like he seems to be very highly accomplished on the field, but he's got a son that he's being a great father, highly accomplished there as well. I think that's an even bigger, greater accomplishment when it comes to being a great father and having his son give that speech like he did. That's amazing as well. But just looking at him here on this field too, he just seems very intelligent on the field and off the field. If I can get my words together, right? Man. Oh my gosh, I can't even think of it right now. What he reminds me of doing that. It's, I don't know, isn't it, there's this, I don't know if it's all fish that you see like just jumping out and then they jump back in. I've seen it on like shows or movies or something somewhere, but that's what he reminds me of doing that. Like he's just like, man, he just goes back in. Like a dolphin or something. Look at him, see his legs and all that? Man, he gets up there and over everyone, though. Look how good he is at that. Oh my gosh. He is such a great runner. Like, no doubt about it. Look at how he just did that. He's good. He reads the field and the defense from the other team very well. And then, like I said, when it comes to traffic on the freeway and switching lanes, like he's just boom, 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 up. Let me go this way, let me go that way. Like he's got it quick too. Very quick when he's reading. Up just striding on in there. He's getting ready. Nope, watch out. Look straight through everyone. Man. Oh my goodness. Like, it's either like it's my will versus your will, and he's not about to be the one that's about to go down. Like, that's his style. He's not giving up. His will is going to be stronger than yours. And let's battle it out. Let me prove it. Ooh, look at him. Man, it's just going. Keeps on going. Like all gas, no brakes. Went out, knew to take it to the outside. No one was able to get to him. Just leaping over and jumping over people. Oh, I like that. I like that a lot. So like, he was like, oh, what are you going to do? Oh, never mind, they got you. Keep going now. Trying to read what 45 was doing. Wow. Gotta just clown for everyone. Keeps on going. And the way he like does his little like kind of like a little stutter step, he'll switch really quick, cut inside, go back out. Like he just his moves and what how he uses them and it moves around out there is great. He was ready, like, come on, let's go. He ain't taking me down. Look at this, like, I would've went down. These guys are like trying to get him down and it is not working. Boom, someone hits his legs, this guy grabs him, he still gets out the way of that, gets out the way of all the mess and takes it all the way there. Just breaking tackles like it's nothing. The Super Bowl that he won at, right? Man. That was a very nice long pass that he caught beautifully. Jeez. What? And none of them are stopping anything that he's doing. Like, those hits and him dipping the shoulder really quick to knock them off, none of that affected his run. Like, he's just smooth. Look at that. Jeez. Oh, wow. That guy was not doing his job at all on defense. He was trying to catch him. You should have tried to do something else after that. Man, because he is gone. Look at him. Wait, come back. Oh, no. No. Now, I've watched Barry Sanders, and looking back at Barry Sanders and now looking at Walter Payton, like, I can say, like, the difference between the two of them is that Barry Sanders is just, he's more elusive when it comes to Walter Payton. Like, he's just more, I want to say more physical, more on the physical side when it comes to his style when he's playing and the way he moves out there. It seems like he likes hitting, like, and he enjoys it. He gets, like, you know, he wants to run right through you. He enjoys to do that. That's what I'm getting from what he does. Nice. Very nice. Nice one hand catch too, that was really good. He's like, oh, stay in there. He got his composure and he's gone. Just look how physical he is though. Guy's in all the mess. He's like, nope, go down. Did he, like, grab onto his helmet? Right? Didn't he do that? Isn't that, like, not okay? Is that what he did, though? It looks like that's what he did. Let me know, guys. Nice, because it looked like something else was going to happen at the end of that, for sure. All right, so, I mean, this is just looking at him Walter Payton is great.
Special. You know, he's very compassionate. Oh. He's a guy who feels for all his teammates and for people in general. He's just he's a class act. There's no question about it.
I think maybe the spirit of the way he played the game is the greatest thing he's leaving. He's a great player, but yet he's one of the guys. The hardest thing for him giving up the game is the game itself, not only playing, but practicing and being around his teammates and just being one of the guys. I think that's what he's going to miss the most.
A guy like Payton has to be considered with people like Jim Thorpe and with Bronco Nagurski and Red Grange and guys like that, legends, because that's what he is. He's, you know, played this game with so much enthusiasm and so much talent that no one ever be a football player that's made an impact on professional football the way he has.
Seems like he was loved by, like, a ton of people. Like, he had a great amount of fans. And it looks like if I look back and think about what I've seen on Wikipedia, he didn't play for a long time, so I don't know, maybe it looks like he left, he decided he was done, or what happened with that, but it seems like you know, everyone thought very high about him, what a ton of great things to say about him as a person and individual. So was a great person on and off the field, so that's just great to see. And then an amazing father, a son who looked up to him. I know when his father passed, that probably anyone's father passes, it's you know, something hard to deal with. But with that being said, just watching him out here on the field and watching him in action and seeing how physical he is and, you know, what an amazing running back he is and the way he runs his course and what he does out there and just goes full force when he was on that field was absolutely amazing to see. I enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. You guys, don't forget to take a look down in the description and go ahead and get my Twitter. Follow me on Twitter, you guys. Subscribe, give the video a thumbs up, do all those great things for me, join me, hit that bell so you guys can get the alerts for the videos when they do go up, and make sure you guys comment below, answer my questions for me for sure too as well. So I will see you all next time.